This is Samuel from scentheart.com, and today I'm reviewing the Perry Ellis 360 perfume oil type from scentheart. You know, this perfume oil type was inspired by the Perry Ellis perfume, which is doing great. It's doing amazing. The other day I was looking at Amazon on a fragrance session, and the perfume was among the top 20 at least. You know, I would say the top 10, and I don't know, you know, but I know it's like right there. You know, I was like, oh wow, this perfume is like still like a best and a top seller, even, you know, today. And it's been a while this thing came out. This thing came out at least 11 years ago, because it came out in 1995, the perfume, you know. So here you have it, the perfume oil type. You could go to scentheart.com and grab a bottle. But real quickly, I know I usually go over the bottle. For those of you that's first time visiting the channel, you know, it's like 0.033 ounce. The liquid, it's like a light brown liquid. It has a capsule that comes off, and there is a roll-on that you could apply on your neck, on your arms, anywhere that you choose. You know, I would say be kind of gentle with the application of this, because I'll say try a little bit first and then see how it does on your skin, you know, how it projects, and then that way you wouldn't apply too much or too little. But I'll get into the notes you know, briefly. But you know, this is an interesting perfume, and when I reviewed it, you know, I remember I had it, I applied it, and the first thing I got was a fresh, clean smell. You know, so I know I've been reviewing a couple of fresh, clean perfumes of late, and I mean, I love fresh, clean smell perfumes, you know, citrusy perfumes, you know. But when I reviewed this, I was like, oh man, I hope this is not this is gonna be like, you know, a fresh. You know, I've reviewed so many of them already, and you know, I hope there's something more to start, you know, to it. So then I smelled it and I was like, okay, whatever, you know. So I just kept, you know, doing whatever I was doing. And then after a while, I went back to smell it, and I said, oh, this thing does smell like soap with mint, you know. So I'm like, oh wow, like, you know, soap with mint. Like, how do they combine that? I mean, that I like mint, so I mean, you know, it's okay, it's nice, you know. And then after about a couple of hours, let's say 2 hours after that, I went to smell it, and I was like, wow, I was amazed. You know, this thing had turned into something else. You know, I smelled it, and this thing had like a mask, you know, leather thing going on in there. So I'm like, wow, like this thing from here to here. So I'm like trying to figure out what it is, and it was like leather mask, you know, playing in the background. I couldn't quite put my nose and like pick out exactly what was going on in there, you know. But the transformation was amazing. I was like, wow, this one is changing into something else. And then after it finally dried down, this one has become like, to me, it smelled like the most beautiful leather I have smelled. You know, this one was so like, it was so nice, you know, it was so nice smelling. There was no citrus, it was just like a nice, beautiful leather sitting on my skin, you know. So I'm like, wow, you know, this is amazing, you know. And then that made sense to me, the 360, you know, because this thing was designed to take you on a 360 experience, right? And you know, this is one of the fragrances that I cannot sit here and tell you about it. It's like you have to go and get a bottle and try it for yourself. It's kind of those movies that you watch, but you cannot tell somebody. You're trying to explain to somebody, but they wouldn't get it unless they watch the movie with you. You know, this is the same thing. This is what's reminiscent of the same thing. Like, among all the perfume that I have smelled, among the perfume in my collection that I have smelled to date, this is the most unique perfume oil that I've tried in terms of the character and the personality and how it transformed and changed so much, you know, and took me on a 360 experience. You know, it was like a trip, you know, took me tripping, you know. So I absolutely love this perfume. It is very, very unique. I'll say 10 out of 10. If I could give it 11, I'll definitely give it 11, because it is very, very unique. for versatility. I know it's marketed towards men, but hey, I think women could also like get away with it, you know, based on the changes that it went through. Young people, you know, basically perfume, I don't like even categorizing ages and putting labels on it, because perfume basically is like, you know, anybody could, depending on who you are, you could wear, you know, whatever perfume that you want, you know, and you know, and certain perfume might fit certain situations and stuff like that. But once you try, like, I bet you'll be able to tell or be able to decide which occasion to use the perfume. But for longevity, this perfume does last a good while, you know, like at least 4 or 5 hours it will give you. But I say, like, it will change because it's not linear, you know. So, you know, as far as what you're looking to, like, stay to, like, it's going to change, you know, and it's going to give you, it's going to be intriguing to you, and it's going to be, like, excite your sensory buds, you know. So, for longevity, it's really up to you. I cannot really say for longevity for you. But for projection, it's okay. You know, it's very decent. You know, it's a very personal, it's like a very personal fragrance, you know, because you're going to go to the journey, because it does not really project like a beast, you know. But, you know, I'll say out of 10, maybe 6 or 7 for the projection. So it will be good for the springtime, spring, early summer. I know we are in spring now. Winter, you know, wouldn't be ideal to use this perfume, a perfume oil, I'll say. But for spring, summer, perfect, you know, perfect. You know, you're going to have an awesome personal time with this perfume, you know. And for uniqueness, this is the most unique perfume among my collection to date. You know, for 10 out of 11, you know, 10 out of 10, I'll say 11 out of 10 if I could, you know, because this perfume is very unique. You're taking a journey and, you know, you're going to have an awesome time and an awesome fragrance experience with this perfume, you know. So I cannot say enough. Like I said, this is something that you have to grab your bottle and then experience it, because I was looking at reviews online. I see that most people have had different experiences with this perfume, you know, so they pick the different notes from the perfume, you know. But it's interesting why, you know, this will you know, so for the notes, so for the notes, the top notes was juniper, berries, lemon, and bergamot. You know, so that fresh at the beginning was the juniper berry, and so that freshness was the lemon, the bergamot, and the juniper berries. You know, for the mint, we have lavender, we have sage, and we have Cardanian Frizzy. You know, I don't know what those are, but I couldn't pick up any lavender or any sage or any Cardanian Frizzy. For the base, which is the dry down, I had I was having leather, you know. Yes, so it was leather and tobacco that was playing in, you know, to me, you know. For the base notes, we have vetiver and musk, and then woody notes. So those was, you know, what you get out from it, you know, from the base, you know. So it's beautiful, beautifully crafted. Those are the notes. You know, like I said, if you want to grab a copy, a bottle, go to scenthunt.com. I'll personally ship you a bottle of this perfume oil. And take care. Let me know what you got out from this. Make sure you comment, like, subscribe. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, because that's the only way you're going to get my videos when they do come out. Take care, and until next time.